Hello you lovely people and welcome to this week's Tuesday Talkies video. Kaur Navdi left a video suggestion for us on Instagram where she says, suggest ways on how you can reduce time on social media without using external apps on your phone. So as I was thinking about this video topic, I started to think about why must we reduce spending time on social media? And that's how I have arrived at this week's video topic, which is reasons you must spend lesser time on social media. Let's begin. Reason number one, you must spend lesser time on social media is because that is time that you could be using to improve yourself and your life. I mean, spending a reasonable amount of time on social media is fine because the reality is we all like to be entertained. A lot of us work very hard through the day and we like taking 5 or 10 minutes here and there to entertain ourselves. That's fine. But the problem arises when the amount of time you're spending on social media is now actively affecting other areas of your life. It's affecting your work, or it might be affecting your health. It could be affecting your relationships. And that is when the problem arises. The problem arises when you make a long list of things to do, and at the end of the day, you're like, where the hell did the day go by? I still haven't been able to achieve most of the things that I have on my to-do list. But then you did spend a couple of hours on your phone scrolling through various social media. That is when the problem arises. Our time is such a precious commodity. And if you're someone who constantly wants to upskill, who is ambitious, who wants to achieve many things in life, but often feel like you just don't have the time to do that, one reality check could be get onto your phone settings and look at how much time you're spending on social media. If you feel it's reasonable, that's fine. But if you begin to see that you're spending 2 hours, 3 hours, 4 hours per day on social media, and mind you, a lot of us don't even realize we're doing this, that time on those apps just goes away like that. And that is all time that you could be using on improving yourself and your life situation. Reason number two why you must spend lesser time on social media is because after a point, it starts affecting you mentally. Let's be very real. A lot of us post the best, the most amazing, the most positive aspects of our life on social media. Not a lot of people talk about hard reality or, you know, the low points of their life. And that's just how it is. That's human nature, right? We like to post what looks aesthetically pleasing on someone's feed as they're scrolling by. And if you're sitting in bed wearing your pajamas, scrolling through your feed and looking at other people's lives that are like, look at me, my life is so amazing. At some point, if you're not careful, it's going to start affecting you mentally. It's easy to start feeling like their life is so much better than mine, or why isn't my life as exciting as theirs? Oh, look at this couple, they're always holidaying somewhere. What am I doing? Or they look so happy, why am I not so happy? And this can gradually start spiraling into other negative emotions, subconsciously, unknowingly, into low self-worth. You know, subconsciously feeling like I am not worthy enough of that, or I am not capable of achieving that. And this can have a huge negative impact on your mental health. And while it is nice to sometimes look at the high points of someone else's life and leave a nice comment or two, it is very important to not believe everything you see on social media, or rather to not be bogged down by things that you see on social media. And spending lesser time on social media can help you get there. Reason number three you must spend lesser time on social media is because it's not the best for your physical health. We were just now speaking about mental health. Let's look at physical health now. Bending like that, constantly having your neck in that angle and continuously looking at your phone is not the best for your cervical spine, not the best for your neck, and not the best for those of you who don't want a double chin. Not very aesthetically pleasing, this is it now. It's also not very good for your eyes to constantly keep taking in so much of the light from your phone. It's not good for the skin around your eyes, and it's not good for your wrist to keep handling that weight of your phone all of the time. Our phones are so big these days. And for your thumb to keep scrolling constantly like that. We're not made for that. Also, that is time you could be spending on exercising, keeping your phone aside, getting up, getting out of the house, jogging, doing some yoga. So yeah, you have lots of physical benefits from spending lesser time on your phone, lesser time on your social media. Reason number four you must spend lesser time on your social media is so that you can enjoy the other wonders of the world. You can enjoy nature. You can enjoy going out and actually interacting with the world. You can enjoy getting to know yourself. Instead of constantly engaging on the phone, put it aside and spend time with yourself. You are an amazing and interesting person. I know it. I don't know if you know it. I surely know it. So get to know yourself. There are so many wonderful things that creation has made. Leave your phone aside, spend lesser time on social media and engage with these things instead. That will be time well spent. Reason number 5 to spend lesser time on social media is so that you will have now more time to nurture relationships in your life. Yes, social media has opened up all of these amazing pathways that did not previously exist, which we can use to keep in touch with long lost friends, with people in our life, our extended social circle. That is definitely one of the many positives of social media. But the more you spend time on these things, the less you have time to spend with your family, people you're actually living with your friends, pick up the phone, call someone. It's also great. It's nice to engage on social media through messages, but it's also wonderful to have that nice chat either in person or on the phone. And sometimes we might feel like, who has the time for all of these things to make phone calls and all? You go back to your phone, spending time on social media. Check yourself right there. Use this time to nurture the meaningful relationships in your life. Reason number 6 to spend lesser time on social media is to prevent getting addicted. Let's get very, very real. The algorithms on these social media are designed to get you hooked onto their platforms, to make you addicted to this. They want you spending as much of your precious time as you can on their platforms. Any kind of addiction is not good for you. Any kind of addiction is going to have negative impacts on other aspects of your life. And sometimes we can get addicted to these things without even knowing it. It's not like you consciously signed up for this, like I'm going to get addicted to social media. No. Sometimes we're just in denial. We don't even know it. We don't know it's happening. So seriously, open the settings on your phone and check how much time you're spending on all of these apps. And ask yourself the question, are you okay with it? Reason number 7 to spend lesser time on social media is if you are someone who's consciously trying to change their spending habits, i.e. spend lesser and save more, don't spend too much time on social media. Social media is filled with ads, is filled with brand content that is trying to get you to spend your money. Nothing wrong with that. That is the main reason they were built for, and they are doing their thing. But the more time you spend on there, the more time your mind is getting stimulated by all of these apps, these nice looking products. Other people have them and they're so pleased by having them in their life. And you are already trying to control this. This is not really a good place for you to be on, is what I'm saying. If you're trying to consciously spend lesser money, if you already have a problem in that area and you're trying to reel yourself back in, this might help you. Now let's get serious. Let's get down to the crux of this, right? Our attention and our time are so precious. The sad thing is that not a lot of us realize how precious these commodities are. And the sadder part is that other people, other companies realize this. And they are all fighting, all clamoring to get your attention and for you to spend your time on them. Me, look at me, give your attention to me. Hey, look at how nice my product is. Hey, look at how nice my life is. Me, give me your attention. And without even realizing it, we waste away so much of our attention and time on these things. And the moment you realize how invaluable your attention is, you don't need some woman on the internet to tell you why you should be spending lesser time on social media. You will automatically start doing it yourself. Personally, I've been pretty strict with myself on how much time I spend on social media. I try to limit myself to going on social media just twice a day. That's once in the morning after I've had my brunch and once in the night before I'm going to sleep. And this includes WhatsApp. Unless I'm using WhatsApp for some work conversations or whatever, I try not to go on WhatsApp and the other social media during the day. And unless I'm on Instagram trying to post something, trying to learn something, which for me, I mean, I make videos on YouTube. I do spend a lot of time on YouTube trying to learn tips and tricks of this trade. So yeah, I spend time there, but I try to be very intentional about it and very conscious about it. I do slip every now and then, of course. We are all humans, we all make mistakes. For those of you who might be shocked that I go on all of these apps only twice a day, there are people who don't even do that. There are people who spend way lesser time than I do on these apps. There are people who don't even have these apps installed on their phones. And for those of you who are feeling like, don't I think that I'm going to miss important information if I don't go on all of these apps, if I don't check my WhatsApp messages, what if someone is trying to reach me? Hey, if something is important enough, that person can pick up their phone and give me a call. I'll pick up my calls. The important thing is that we learn to live in moderation. I am not saying remove all of these apps from your phone. How can you spend even half a minute on... No, that is not what I'm saying. live your life in moderation. Enjoy everything that comes with the social media apps. I know I do. I love posting on there. I love engaging with people that I really like on there. I love learning new things from there. There are so many things that we can use these apps to for our benefit. So focus on that. But don't go so deep into this rabbit hole that you find it difficult to dig yourself out. That's all I'm saying. So that was this week's video. Don't worry, Navdeep. I definitely am still keeping your suggestion in mind. And that is going to be next week's Tuesday Talkies, where I'm going to talk about how we can reduce our time on social media. So stay tuned. I will see you guys again on Friday with a brand new video. Until then, you guys be happy, stay safe, and bye.